studio for a chat. And he's also going to be performing a new song from his album. Now, he won the show 2 years ago and sold over 1 million records and even won another talent show since.
Yeah, because he can. One more clue, here's a Geordie. Can you guess who it is yet?
That's Rolf Harris,
I know,
no?
But okay. He says that.
OK, Joe McElderry, of course. Before we say hello, let's take a look at this. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Geordie Joe stole the nation's hearts when he won the X Factor back in 2009. His debut single, The Climb, went to number one with his album entering the top five the following year. Since then, Joe has performed all over the country as well as winning another talent competition, Pop Star to Opera Star, which became the inspiration of his second album, Classic. Now Joe is getting us all in the festive spirit with his third album, Classic Christmas.
So here he is, Joe McElderry, everyone!
Hello.
Joe, great to see you. Good to see you on the sofa. Last week, you was meant to be a little bit poorly.
Yeah, I had food poisoning.
Really?
Really ill.
What have you been eating? Not too many.
It was a curry. It was honestly, I couldn't even stand up. Otherwise, I would have came in and soldiered on, but I couldn't. I was in that much agony.
Quite dramatic, Joe.
Well, I'm not the dramatic. I never. That was the first sick day I've ever pulled since being a singer.
Really?
So you know, I must have been bad.
Well, we're here to talk about your new album, but we'll get on to that in just a moment. First, we want to ask you your opinion on the X Factor being a former winner. What do you make of Little Mix winning?
Oh, I'm so happy they won. I'm really happy. I'm really good friends with Jade.
Oh, are you?
We grew up, she literally lives like 10 minutes round the corner, and we grew up together. We used to sing together at charity events.
Why, are there something in the water?
Exactly, you see. So I voted for them last night, and I was desperate for them to win, and they were the best. They were the most consistent through the whole thing, so I think they totally deserved it.
Tell us something we don't know about Jade.
Yeah, go.
She's very shy. I mean, I don't know whether you get to see that, but she's one of them kind of singers where she gets really, really nervous before. Mm. So when she first went on, she was phoning and she's like, what do I do? How do I do with all of this? And I was like, just enjoy it, you know, but I think they've really enjoyed it.
Joe, how would you have felt if on the X Factor you didn't get through, but then they gave you a lifeline and said, we're going to put you in a band? How would you have felt about that?
I actually had that conversation with my mum just before I went to boot camp. She said, what will you do if they do that? Because you need to bear that in mind, that might happen. And I said I wouldn't do it. I said I wouldn't be in a boy band. I'm such a perfectionist with my singing that I couldn't handle relying on three other people. It would just stress us up so much in case they didn't deliver as well as I wanted them to. So I don't know whether I could do that.
Now, talking about that, there is a lot of pressure on the girls now, especially with Spice Girls comparison and stuff. Do you think they're going to be able to handle it?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think if you can handle the 12 weeks that involves being on the X Factor, it pretty much sets you up for everything that you need to handle, because nothing will ever top the pressure that they've gone through just right now. So yeah, totally. And I mean, they've just got to enjoy it. You know, there's all these things circling. They're going to be the next this, that, and the other. But I think no matter what happens, they're going to do well. And I think they've just got to enjoy it. Mm.
Joe, I remember with your year, when you won it, you was held back for a particular period of time. Like, what are the reasons for that? Because I felt if you'd have maybe been releasing your single a little bit
earlier. They did it with this. It started when they did it with Leona, didn't they? And she went off and recorded. And I think a lot of people, they tend to do that with every winner. But I think you can't use the same generic, like, it's not a rule book. Every winner's different, every fan base is different. And I think it just depends on when the music's ready. And I think with Little Mix, they should just go for it, and when it's ready, put it out there.
What are your thoughts on the winner's single this year, Cannonball?
It's not what you would expect, is it?
No.
But I think, I mean, it's going to go to number one,
surely. It's a beautiful song, and the girls sing it incredibly well.
They sing it really well. I wasn't keen on Marcus's version. I think their version was genuinely better.
No, the girls sing it very well. Now, on to you, sir.
Yes.
You're here to talk about your new album.
Yes.
Now, your last album, Classics, this is Classic Christmas.
It is, yes.
Tell us about it.
It's basically just an album full of my favourite Christmas songs. You've got Last Christmas on there, When a Child Is Born.
That's the one that you're releasing, is it?
No, yeah, Last Christmas is the one I'm releasing.
Yeah.
Driving Home for Christmas we've got on there.
Oh, I love
that
one.
Bit of a different version. Oh, Come All Ye Faithful. It ranges from, like, proper pop festive tunes to a bit more of the kind of big ballads and orchestrated songs.
Hey, Joe, we've got a clip of Oh, Come All Ye Faithful.
Yes, this is the one.
Let's...
voice.
Thank you.
So later on, you're going to be performing When a Child is Born.
Yes.
What do you prefer singing, like the more poppy stuff or the more classics?
Well, I've just come off tour last week, and that was kind of, the show was split in half between the kind of classic stuff, the classic album, and the first pop album. And the classic stuff's easier to sing because it doesn't ruin your voice as much. Whereas the pop stuff, you're not singing properly really when you're singing pop.
Do you think this is the training that you had on Pop Star to Opera Star, though?
Totally, yeah, because you breathe properly, you kind of sing from your stomach where you're supposed to sing from instead of, like, straining your voice. So I would always be at the first half of the show, I'd be like getting through it, and then the second half would just be a breeze.
Do you feel like Christmas has been around for quite a while? Was you like filming that video in October, standing next to the Christmas tree?
Yeah, this is the longest Christmas lead up I've ever had. It was when the heat wave happened in London. Remember when we had that heat wave? And I was going in the studio singing like, "Oh, come all ye faithful." We'll film that in the middle of October when that heat wave was on, and then we're having to like block the sun with screens and everything to make it look all wintry. It was very strange.
So you're telling me it was fake snow?
Cool. It was the snow off James Bond. There you go.
Really?
We're made up for it.
007 snow.
Yeah. How about the Only Way Is Essex? They're actually putting out a Last Christmas, I think.
Yes.
How does it actually compare to your version?
I hope they're very different.
Were you cross when you heard that they were releasing that?
No, you know what it is? Christmas is one of those times of year. The music industry, it's the busiest time of the year. And whenever you release an album or anything, you know, I released the album last week, and it was the busiest week in the music industry. So it's all about the fun of it and just enjoying being in the charts alongside other artists.
Yeah.
And you know, the Only Way Is Essex. I'm not sure they're the best singers in the world, but more the merrier. The more the merrier.
So you're performing at the O2 Arena soon. Tell us about that.
I'm performing for the Nutcracker, the big ballet show. But I'm not dancing in it. But I'm basically kind of opening the show. We've got a 72-piece orchestra, and we're going to do 6 shows, and I'm going to sing some of the Christmas stuff and some of the stuff off the classic. I'm really excited.
Amazing.
It's going to be amazing. They've got, like, an amazing set and everything, so it's going to be fun.
So what are your plans for Christmas, anyway?
I have 3 days off.
No way.
Yeah, I have Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, and then I travel down to London to the O2 on Boxing Day for the shows, do 6 shows there, and then I'm flying to somewhere in Europe for a skiing holiday. Yeah, I'm going skiing with all the family.
Have you skied before?
Yeah, we go every year. It's kind of a tradition. So there'll be about 11 of us, and we'll go off and just chill out. I can't wait. I'm really excited for a holiday now.
Yeah, and if Father Christmas could bring you anything in the world, what would it be? Mine would be the little metal things you put in the collars of shirts. That's how old I am.
You could have told me that a few weeks ago.
Or a non-slip yoga mat. That's where I am at in
life.
What
do I want? I think just some chill time. I just want to eat loads of food and do nothing for about 3 weeks. If Santa can bring that, then I'll be more than happy.
So you're going to behave when it comes to the après ski? You're on the slopes, hard down the slopes.
I might have a few, you know, few cheeky
Baileys
drinks.
Baileys and ice?
Yeah, maybe.
So what are the plans for 2012?
We're already talking about the next album, which is quite scary, but I'm really excited. And, yeah, can't wait to get back in the studio
again. Classic Easter?
Classic Easter memories. Or classic Mother's Day, you never know. That's before, isn't it?
Joe, thank you so much for coming in. Big kisses.
Pleasure.
Have
thank
a lovely Christmas.
Thank you very much.
It's Joe McElderry with a Christmas classic, When a Child is Born.
We'll see you tomorrow, 6:25. Bye-bye.
See you, yes.
A ray of hope flickers in the sky. A tiny star lights up way up high. All across the land dawns a brand new morn. This comes to pass when a child is born. A silent wish sails the 7 seas. The winds of change whisper in the trees. And the walls of doubt crumble, tossed and torn. This comes to pass when a child is born. A rosy hue settles all around. You got the feel. You're solid ground. For a spell or two, no one seems forlorn. This comes to pass when a child is born. Child is born. This comes to pass when a child is born.